Hello please, welcome back to my channel. And today in this video, as you can tell from the title, I'm gonna be talking about the fashion trends for 2021. So this is the first video that I made in 2021, and honestly, there are so many things going on, so does the fashion trend. So I have been sorting out the one that I like specifically for you guys, because there's too many and too much to talk about in one video. So this is just my personal opinion about what I love for the fashion trend 2021, and I wish to share them with you. So without further ado, let's get into this video. So the first trend that I'd like to talk about is the cutout designs. And this design specifically reminds me of Kurt Geyer and Nathalie Rault. They are known for this cutout details on their designs, and I really love them. They just give this sexy feminine touch to a dress that somebody could wear, and it will look good on literally any occasion. Might be a little bit too obscene for some occasion, but I still really love it. I feel like it's unique and nobody has ever done this design before. It's something new, something fresh. I really love it. I feel like this trend could go on the while more, because I feel like it's still pretty new and people are still discovering new silhouettes to put on some certain designs, and I feel like this could work wonder for a lot of girls that love sexy feminine touch. Speaking of feminine, it leads us to the second point, which is the masculine silhouette. So usually this trend works with plain tees, oversized tee, or oversized blazer, and then it would give this really masculine boxy silhouette on the shoulder part by applying an extra layer of shoulder pads here. As you can see, it's going on quite a while now. It just gives this extra smart finishing and smart look to a person, a really clean, sleek look. And also to make it look a little bit more feminine, you can always wear a belt to cinch in the waist, and it gives it the very nice hourglass shape on your body. It just works so beautifully and I love it. So in the contrary of the smart and sleek look, because due to quarantine and we have all been rocking our loungewear at home and all these really comfy jacket or maybe sweatpants and sweatshirts, and this is a major trend in 2021 as well, since the quarantine isn't over yet. So yeah, and I've seen several new brands in Malaysia, as far as I know, Shop Founders and Mother Chuckers, they have been coming up with this similar designs of really nice and clean, minimal sweater and sweatpants. I personally am not a fan of sweatshirt and sweatpants, but because the trend is in, and then I really like to try to wear them more because I find it really comfy, and I really want to purchase more of it because I find it really convenient to be wearing it at home. Well, speaking of laundry, moving forward to the next point, which is oversized pants. Those small tops but big pants kind of look, you know, I hands down 100% is that kind of girl. I love small tops and big pants, and I'm really glad that this has come into trend this year. Recently, I've purchased like so many oversized loose-fitted trousers and jeans, and it has obviously elevated my look, and it makes it look so much more put together, and it's not baggy, it's not super formal, it's just really casual, it's somewhere in between there. This is a very versatile piece. I would also consider it as an essential piece to include in your wardrobe if you were to plan to build a capsule wardrobe. Honestly, speaking of capsule wardrobes, I actually plan to make a video about capsule wardrobes in the future, but not anytime soon. And I am nowhere near ready to settle down to limit myself on what I should wear daily, and yeah, I shall make that video in the future, but not anytime soon. Alright, so this is all I have to say about the loose-fitted bottom jeans or trousers. It is very seasonless. You can wear them in summer, you can wear them in winter. It's honestly my favorite thing to wear at all times, and really recommend you guys to go get some. So moving forward to my fifth favorite trend, it will be a bell-bottom trousers or jeans, just anything bell-bottom. It's, yeah, again, the same. It's very versatile. It's also very in trend right now. But I really like the belt, the flare design. It just elongates your leg like magic. I don't know how. But yeah, it looks so good. So for the sixth trend that I'll be talking about is ripped knits, which include sweaters, sweater vest, cardigans, ripped skirt. I don't know, for some reason this trend is just super in right now. This material, I've seen a lot of this material going on in Altuzara, Kaut Geia, Simone, and this, I don't know, I just really love it. I feel like it's again very seasonless and you can basically wear them in winter or summer. Suitable for someone like me who always lives in summer but still want to keep up with the winter trend. I believe this material derived from the cardigan trend at this one part of 2020. There are so many people wearing this Brandy Melville style cardigan, like a set or with a checkered skirt, something like that. Here's a picture. And many brands afterwards have used a lot and transformed this material into something a little bit more rustic and a little bit more modern, and I really like it. I feel like you couldn't go too casual or too formal with this material, and pieces like this are usually very, very versatile. So yeah. So the next trend that I have to talk about is bra tops or bralette. Again, it's too obscene for me to pull it off here where I live, but I started seeing this trend everywhere after Jacquemus Spring-Summer 2021 ready-to-wear collection. Honestly, Jacquemus is now my top-tier favorite designer that I really look up to. I love the aesthetic, I love the style, and I absolutely love their latest collection. And obviously, the bralette top trend isn't going anywhere after Jacquemus launched their newest collection. So yeah, so as we have bra tops, we also have corsetries. And I feel like quarantine has everybody reminiscing about the past historical silhouette. And I feel like this trend has been going on since 2020, and it's not the newest trend, but it's my top favorite trend. Because I personally love to wear the more slim-fitting garments and body tight garments in general. So I've been into this trend for a very long time now. I even made several videos about it, and you can check them out. This trend, I believe, it started off with Dion, Alexander McQueen, Dion Lee and Matthew Williams, and they created beautiful pieces, but it's a bit too high-end and luxury for everybody to reach. So some mass production fashion houses actually recreate these similar pieces but sell it with a more accessible and more affordable prices, like you can find on House of CB, Fashion Nova. I mean, House of CB isn't the most affordable brand, but it is compared to Dior or Alexander McQueen, I believe, like couture brand like them. Yeah, and then I'm sure you can find them on Taobao, but then I have not bought any of those corset pieces from Taobao because I don't really trust them with such intricate pieces like corsets. Yeah, so moving on to the next point, we have layering. And by layering, I mean this trend has been going on since 2020 as well, but I believe it will still be a thing in 2021 because it is so flexible. Like, you can basically layer a corset on shirts and make a different look. And
then you can layer a sweater on shirt, and then you can layer a sweater vest on shirt, and then you can layer a dress on a tight-fitting turtleneck long-sleeve shirt.
There are so many ways of layering it, and all of the ways looks extremely beautiful, and it's by far one of my favorite trends still, and I wish for this trend to go on for the longest time. And now for the last trend that I'm gonna end with is strappy garments. This trend, I've seen many designers making them, some OG designs by Nancy Dojaka or maybe Otto Linger. I've also spotted a little bit more like minimal ones by Jacquemus, and also Dion Lee, and also again Natalie Wall. Okay, so regarding to this design, I believe that not everybody would actually give it a try, but I would. But it is not everybody's cup of tea. I just find it really unique and special. It is something different. So yeah, that's all for this video. It concludes the top 10 favorite trends of mine in one video, and I'm really happy to share it with you guys. Again, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and if you want to see more video in the future, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and leave down a comment on what you think is the trendiest and what's your favorite trend so far. Yeah, until then, I'll see you guys in my very next video. Bye. I don't